guys hope you're having a great day.
Hope you're having a great life.
All right, it's time to visit Rainbow, the song Stargazer. When I did my very first Child in Time video by Deep Purple, everyone was telling me, if you like this guitarist, then you need to see or hear Stargazer by Rainbow. They told me that the singer is Dio, I'm pretty sure. Don't quote me on that, but I'm pretty sure
they said. I love Dio. Like, I think he's a phenomenal. He's the guy who started the rock horns.
Really?
Yeah, dude. His grandma did. I'm pretty sure if the story's right. His grandma was she used to do it to, like, ward off evil.
I didn't know that.
He was like, oh, that's pretty cool. I'm taking that. And so his grandma was the one who, yeah, it's crazy.
I don't know. And they said that the guitarist from Deep Purple, Child in Time, is the guitarist in this band.
Oh, man, I'm excited. I have not heard much of Rainbow.
I haven't even heard of the band, the name, you know, Rainbow at all until they told me. So we're going to go ahead and dive into it, guys.
Sweet.
To be that groovy either,
dude, because the drums came in, it's like you expected it to be like up tap, like this is gnarly, dude.
In the comments, I better see the drummer's name, I'll freak out. I swear, that was insane.
And I want you to know that drum fill, I've heard it in like three songs this week. Like the way he did that, that means like he's that influential that it's like, cool, let me just, I mean, he's probably not the one who started that, but the way that was done was so like.
Groovy, like jazzy.
Dude, I've literally heard like that's like somebody's heard this Rainbow record and been like, "Oh, dude, I'm putting this in my song." Like
three different songs. I don't blame them. It's so dirty, dude.
It's just, so good.
It's like you're teasing the fill. It's not just
dude.
It's like,
oh man,
you know what I mean? So just
okay.
All right, bring it back. 10 seconds. We're gonna dive back into it.
Tower!
makes it right at the end. I literally like closed my eyes and was like feeling that the whole
dude, that last like that last
that was
like,
8 minutes?
Dude, the last 4 minutes of that the last four minutes took me to space, dude, where you're just like locked in that like groove, you know? Because I had that like that
yeah, dude.
Yeah, just that repetitive. Oh my god. But like it was okay when they did it. You know what I mean? Like some bands can get away with it, some can't.
Yeah,
you know
this, I mean? Is a, like, this is a band that can get away with that.
Like having like a riff that you kind of like loop for a minute, you know, just to build the emotion. Yeah. Some bands it sounds like formulated and processed, but other bands it's like, oh, that's just their groove. You know what I mean?
Because I'm usually super good at like telling what instruments are in whatever, but like there's so many little tiny textural stuff they started throwing in like slightly. It could have been a mandolin. I know there was some strings that came in.
Yeah,
dude,
I heard that too.
Oh man, Dio.
Their command over their instruments was immaculate, and his command over his vocal tone and pitch was just insane.
It was interesting to me because like, of course, he's got a phenomenal high register, right? But it was, there is that trope in like, and like this era of music, like 70s, honestly 80s music, both of them kind of the same thing, where it's like, they built energy by going slightly higher, right? Like. Hit a note here, then like, okay, I want to show off like a little bit more. I want to build more emotion. I'm going to go higher, and then if I'm going to build one more, I'm going to go higher, right? And we even heard that in the Deep Purple song, right? Not a bad thing. It's definitely not a bad thing, but it is the norm. It is the usual. It's like the go-to because it's easy. Like, like it's just like on a guitar solo. Like, how do I make this feel more emotional? Oh, well, I go a little bit higher so it sounds like it's more intense. Mm-hmm. It was really interesting to me that. He didn't do that vocally. Like, he, of course, he went high a few times, right? But more often than not, when he's getting ready to build to a big part, he actually went lower, which is
really
so, because it's so abnormal.
I've only heard one Dio song in the past, and that's what he showed me the song Holy Diver, like a year ago.
That's, I actually have heard very little Dio as well. That's my favorite Dio song.
This is my second song having him sing.
I actually don't know if I've heard any Rainbow then, because I was actually attributing Holy Diver to Rainbow, and I'm pretty sure it's just like Dio. It's just like
self-titled. Yeah, I think it's just Dio.
Okay.
So, damn, but dude, this was a phenomenal song. Just the,
it was
just
so
the
good.
Instrumental, just
that was
all
so
of it.
Good.
The whole, like, rounded, package. Like, package deal of the song.
Dude, well, thank you guys so much.
Yeah, that was a fantastic suggestion I got like 3 months ago or something. That I've been like holding in my back pocket ready to like whip it out like, just randomly. I'm like, all right, let's do it. Let's just do Rainbow. Let's do it right now. You know what I mean?
Oh.
So with that said, I will see you guys next time. Go ahead and like if you want to like it. Go ahead and subscribe if you want to vote in polls and just see when new videos come out. Go ahead and comment the first time you heard Stargazer or any other Rainbow song and what other Rainbow songs we might want to hear in the future. With that said, hope you guys have a fantastic day.